The clip I'm about to share with you about whether moving slowly in our yoga practice is actually stronger is a clip from a longer, fuller course of mine called The Science of Strength 2.0. So I just wanted to let you know that and give you a little heads up because you'll be dropping into just a single point within this longer course. And just to give you a heads up of what I've put together here, it's two different clips that I kind of spliced and put together. And in the first clip, I talk about what exercise science research tells us about the connection between our movement speed during strength training and the relationship to strength adaptations. So we first kind of establish a little base of what the research suggests about strength. And then in the second clip, we'll apply those insights to our actual yoga practice. So first a little strength science followed up by applying it to yoga. And then just FYI that if you're interested, you're more than welcome to take my full course, The Science of Strength 2.0. It's a 4-hour course and anyone can take it, but I did design it with kind of the yoga population in mind. And it also counts as continuing education hours with Yoga Alliance. So if you're interested in the full course, you can actually take the course for free with a 7-day free trial on my website. And the link to the course is in the caption here. So feel free to head on over and take the course for free if you're interested. Now, with all of that said, let's turn our attention to this clip. So taking a closer look at speed, and sometimes you'll hear this referred to as tempo. Tempo is kind of the strength training term for like the relationship between the speed of the concentric and the eccentric phases of an exercise, and also the any pause you might make in between those two. We're not going to dive super deeply into tempo, but tempo is a word you might hear when you're hearing about speed. So as I've tried to explain already, the sign that you're using enough effort in your strength training practice is that you've got an element of slow involved to the lifting. And we just need to note that the reps need to be slow because we're forced to go slowly. But really what's really happening is you're actually using maximal intent. Like you're trying to lift that weight, like with a lot of effort. If you could, you'd lift it fast, but you just can't because you're so tired, or if you're lifting heavy weights, you just can't because they're so heavy, but your intent is maximal. Like you're trying to lift it as fast as you can, but you're forced to lift it slow because it's either so heavy from the very start of your set, or because you've repeated reps enough that you've accumulated fatigue and you no longer can lift at that faster pace. So it's just important to realize that we need the slow element is there because we're forced to go slowly. It's not because we volitionally slow the reps down, right? So what I'm trying to say is like, I'm not saying that when you're strength training, you should go out of your way to slow down, because that's what I think we think sometimes. This is kind of a misconception that I find, is that we think it's just, it's like going slow per se in and of itself that's stronger. And it's not that, it's just that you're going slow because you have to, because it's so hard. So if you volitionally slow your pace down, if you go out of your way to consciously slow it down, if you slow it down when you could have lifted it faster, then you're not at your effort edge. You're not at your effort edge. So that's why it's not really a good idea to go out of your way to volitionally slow the reps down. It just needs to be slow because it has to be slow, because you're forced to go slow. And like I kind of already mentioned about lifting with maximal intent, and then as we fatigue, our maximal intent will naturally be slower. So as I also kind of said, tempo is the speed of the lift lower phases. Sometimes we hear that it's good to deliberately slow the speed down in order to elongate TUT, or time under tension. That's something that we tend to hear out there. Now, this is a bit of a complex topic. You can really dive into the weeds with it, and I've included like a reference for you to go do that. But I'm just kind of offering like a summary of what the research seems to suggest. Research suggests that there is not a clear benefit to doing this, to volitionally slowing down in order to increase time under tension. There isn't a clear benefit to doing this, not for strength or for muscle growth. So when it comes to strength, remember strength and muscle growth are different. They're distinct. When it comes to strength, what we want is maximal intent on the concentric. So that the concentric, just so we know, that's the lifting up phase. So we want maximal intent on the concentric and a controlled eccentric. And we will have negative impacts on our strength gains otherwise. So in this picture, what I'm showing here, that's called a front raise. That exercise starts with the kettlebell down, like down, say, on my resting on my thighs. And then I lift the kettlebell forward and up with straight arms. So in a front raise, the concentric phase is the, in all strength exercises, concentric phase is the lifting phase. So the concentric is when I lift up. And then the eccentric would be when I lower it down. So when my goal is strength, I just want to be using my maximal intent on the concentric and then a controlled eccentric, which means, so controlled means we're not going out of our way to slow it down, but we're also not dropping it. If you drop it, then just gravity is taking it down, right? So it just means use a controlled lower down. So that's the strategy you generally want for strength. And when it comes to muscle growth, it does seem that research suggests that you can slow down the eccentric, the lower, and it won't hurt your muscle growth gains, but it doesn't generally seem to enhance the gains. So the kind of conclusion, the suggestion is just like if someone wants to slow down the eccentric and if their goal specifically is muscle growth and not strength, then that's fine. They can slow down the eccentric up to about 10 seconds. Research suggests if you slow down longer than 10 seconds, that actually will work against your muscle growth gains. So in that case, it is okay to slow down, but it's not going to enhance them. But if your goal is strength, then you actually don't want to slow down the eccentric. You want maximal intent on the concentric and a controlled eccentric. So, and this is true. For most of our purposes, we really don't need to overthink speed and tempo. Really, the self-selected natural pace that your body moves in strength training is generally just fine. So it's not something we need to like, okay, as I lift, I need to maximally, you know, use my maximal intent and then I need to do a controlled lower. Like, I wouldn't think about that. I would just lift the weight or do your reps or whatever you're doing. And for most of the time, and for most of our purposes, it just, we don't need to think about it. Our body will naturally perform the strength training in a way that will meet these parameters that we want to meet. So don't overthink it. I'm just having us think about it here because it helps us to learn more about the body questions. Another great question that I think about a lot, because I know I used to think this, that like, I used to think that slower was always stronger. That was something that I would say in my yoga classes, like slower is stronger, go slower, slow it down. But now that I understand more about strength science and about speed and like what you actually want for effort and for strength adaptations, my question is, do we move slowly in yoga because we're forced to move slowly? Like, is it, we're moving slowly because it's so hard that we have to go slow? Or are we moving deliberately slowly in yoga when we actually could move more quickly? So if you remember back to what I talked about with the speed tempo thing, it was just like, a sign that we're exhibiting high effort is that our lifting speed is slow. But the caveat there is that we don't want to go out of our way in strength training to deliberately slow it down. We're not trying to volitionally slow it down because then our effort, that effort edge decreases and we're not there anymore. It needs to be slow because the movement is so hard that we have to lift it slow. So in a yoga context, when we go slowly, could we actually go faster? Are we deliberately slowing it down when we could have gone faster? And I think the answer to that is yes. And I don't think it's bad to move slowly in yoga at all because yoga has so much to provide. It's not so much about strengthening. But yeah, if we're moving deliberately slowly in yoga when we could move more quickly, like in a strength training context, that would be a recipe for working against your strength gains. Like you don't want to do that typically. So then it's like, well, if that's what we do in yoga, how strengthening could that be, right?